Hello, I'm Dr. David Clark. Today we're going to talk about composite finishing. Now, composite finishing is really different than anything else that we've looked at under the microscope. It's different than gold, it's different than acrylic, different than amalgam, porcelain. It's a completely different animal. So we've put together a very interesting and beautiful way to do minimally invasive, infinity edge, beautiful, natural looking composite finishes. Now, it should take between 30 seconds and 3 minutes, depending on the tooth, to do this beautiful finish. And it's a little counterintuitive. It's not what you're going to expect. One of the problems with traditional composite finishing is that it's not smooth, and it's too flat. So when we use discs or some of these systems that they sell you to polish composite, they don't work very well, they're overpriced. So there's a lot of things I'm not going to use today, and we won't even talk about them. I don't want to waste your time. So what we're also not going to talk about is how we do the gross finishing. Then we move to finishing, to polishing. And it's a little bit interesting as far as the sequence. The first thing we're going to do as far as margination and creation of these mamelon grooves that create beautiful natural light reflection is a brownie. Now we're gonna use a traditional brownie. These are, I think they're about a buck. We're going to use this. If you have a electric handpiece, we're gonna change it from a setting of 40,000, I really have two settings, fast and medium, down to about 12,000 RPMs. They have a lot of torque, and that way the brownie doesn't explode. If you run these in your electric, in your air-driven handpiece, that's okay, but remember, if you run them at full speed, they'll explode, and they create a lot of heat. Now, to bring this to the next thing. One of the biggest problems with composite finishing is that we have too much heat generated. So I get these teeth very wet with the brownie, with the pumice, no matter what. You'll notice that if you don't use moisture, the composite will have a matte finish, and that's because you're baking the composite. Once you've overheated it, it gets chalky, and the more you polish it, the chalkier it gets. So I use lots of water. Now the other thing is, it'll also heat up the pulp. So there's a lot of reasons why we don't want to overheat the teeth. So here are the three steps. Number one, we use a brownie. Like I said, about 12,000 RPMs with water. Next thing we use is coarse pumice. That gives us a nice matte finish with omnidirectional scratches. We don't want all the scratches going the same direction. The third thing we use is the jazz polisher. We're going to use a lot of heavy pressure with the jazz polisher, and I give the pressure like this. You should be able to push the patient's head down with the jazz polisher. The finer the polisher, the more pressure I use. Now, that creates a lot of heat. Once again, we've got to spray the tooth with water. All right, so let's review. Step number one of polishing is the brownie. We want to use the brownie at about 12,000 RPMs, about medium speed and a high speed with water. We want to marginate with the brownie because the brownie does not cut enamel. It's a beautiful way to get the infinity edge without cutting the margin open and getting that stupid white line. So the brownie is step number one. We create little grooves, mamelon grooves with the brownie. Number two, we want to use coarse pumice in a disposable cup. And that we use very briefly. Make sure and go back to the well every 3 or 4 seconds. If you're running this disposable cup without fresh pumice every 3 or 4 seconds and it needs to be wet, you're just going to overheat the tooth, waste your time, and bake the composite and get that ugly matte finish. Step number three, the jazz polisher. We spend more time with this. This is diamond impregnated. They're about $10, so make sure that nobody throws these away. We're going to use heavy pressure with this jazz polisher, constant water, and constantly moving the cup so we don't burn a hole with the jazz polisher. You should get a beautiful, moving, living, incredibly smooth finish with the three steps. If you have any questions, send me an email. Thanks.